What are the real differences between the Gibson and the Epiphone Adam Jones signature Les Pauls? Safe to say that when Gibson announced the release of the Adam Jones signature line, I think guitarists around the world rejoiced, certainly a lot of us in guitar here. The enigmatic guitarist of Tool he's crafted his own sort of legacy within, I guess, the Guitar Hero cycle and just the world, I guess, when it comes to Guitar Heroes. So many people are inspired by his riffs, his approach to songwriting, and even just his absolutely colossal tone for being the one guitarist in Tool. So not only did they release a top-of-the-line custom shop model of that guitar, Gibson and, of course, the sister company Epiphone have made it a lot more accessible to fans of Adam Jones, or just anybody who's a fan of kind of a souped-out Les Paul. Fans of Adam can, of course, get themselves either a Gibson Les Paul Standard Adam Jones signature or the Epiphone Custom Les Paul Art Collection Adam Jones right here. On first glance of both the guitars, you would think that, you know, they're pretty much the same, they're the same colour, they've got quite the same configuration, they give certainly that vibe, but what's going on under the hood is definitely a little bit different between the two of them, and today that's what we're going to look at. Adam being a huge advocate for late 70s Les Paul customs, you'll absolutely see any footage of him live, whether it be photos or videos, he'll have this kind of almost green silver burst Les Paul. That's just what happened to those ones in the 70s. They aged and kind of went a bit mad colored, which personally I think is really cool. I'm sure anybody out there will let me know in the comments if they love that as well. Of course, one of the things that makes Adam's Les Pauls so iconic is the fact there's a few kind of mods, which both the Epiphone and the Gibson here have both really faithfully recreated, which, I mean, they just look amazing. So when it comes to both guitars, they are kind of standard Les Paul sort of configuration when it comes to the woods in there. Mahogany body, maple top, ebony board, that's shared between both of them there. So you're going to get that sort of familiar Les Paul weight, and anybody who's a fan of ebony on their board as well will, I think, feel really comfortable between the two of them. Standard Les Paul scale length between the two here as well at 24.75 inches and with orange drop capacitors in both there, so you're getting the kind of top of the line when it comes to just the electronics as well. So what are the differences between both? Well, looking at both guitars, as I said initially, they both do look rather similar, you know, silver burst, single cut Les Paul. Anybody kind of at first glance would think these are pretty much the same, but looking at both in terms of aesthetics, the Gibson model is very much going for that standard look, and that was with inverted commas if my hands weren't full of rather heavy Les Pauls right now. What you're getting with the Gibson model here is, of course, the trapezoid inlays as opposed to the block inlays on the custom here. The binding on both is ever so slightly different as well, that the standard has got your standard neck binding, body binding, just in a single cream colour there. It does look really cool against, especially against that paint finish. Whereas the Epiphone model goes for that more Les Paul custom multi-ply binding on the neck and the body and also on the back as well. Now when it comes to the paint finishes on both, they are both going for that antique silver burst look, obviously, as well. That's exactly what Adam Jones wants, so that's what they get on the guitars. So looking at the Gibson model compared to the Epiphone, they both go for that same vibe on the front, whereas on the back of the Gibson is just a plain black finish, and on the Epiphone, this is of course the Art Collection model here. I'm sure this is the fifth now in the line. This one, if I read it properly, is Self-Portrait As Not Dead Yet by Julie Hefferman, which Julie, I think, did another art collection too, and it looks amazing, but that is on all the backs of the Epiphone models, Much more limited edition, so your one may look slightly different to that. But of course, the silver burst is on the back of the neck and on the sides, much like you would get on a old 70s custom of the same color. The American model also does have a nitro finish, so of course that will wear away a little bit kind of naturally where you play, whereas the Epiphone model does have a poly finish on it, so it'll stay virtually the same kind of through its whole life. Now let me just take all of that massive weight off my legs there and give me a little bit of a break, because we can talk about the pickups in both now. Now, looking at the two again on first kind of face value, they both do look similar with their open faced humbucker in the bridge there, and then the reverse mounted at the neck here. Not to be confused, obviously, with the Peter Greeny that was just released recently, which also has a reverse mounted, but the polarity of that was all changed to affect the sound. This is purely just for cool reasons, to be fair, because that looks cool. So there will be a sound comparison within this video, of course, as well, because I'm absolutely dying to play these through the rig we've made through our Helix today. But for a quick rundown of what is in the Gibson model here, in the bridge, there is a DC high gain custom Gibson humbucker, which they have kind of created themselves to work perfectly with this guitar. And in the neck there as well, there is a Burst Bucker 1. So that's one of Gibson's classic style pickups. You're going to get that real nice warm Les Paul neck tone out of this guitar, no problem at all. Whereas looking into the Epiphone model, it is very, very similar. In the bridge there, we do have a Seymour Duncan SD distortion, and in the neck, there is an Epiphone Pro Bucker in there as well. So both giving a similar sort of vibe, high gain in the bridge, a little bit more mellow on the neck there, but I mean, these guitars are made for riffing, so let us do that on them. We'll be right back. Well, safe to say, I had an absolute ton of fun. I mean, these guitars just kind of like absolutely demand to be put into drop D and riffed on. But obviously with the sound demos there, I did, you know, kind of throw in some other sounds there just to demonstrate that these guitars can do a lot more than just imitation Tool is what I was trying to do there. It's an interesting one because I think anybody maybe associates a signature model with maybe you want to get that person's exact sound, you want to play exactly like them, or you know, potentially them just being your heroes, you're going to have that similar playing and sound if you do look into getting one of these guitars. But I think it's safe to say that with certainly the Gibson model, and me and a few colleagues have had this conversation recently because we all do love these guitars, but there is something to be said with the Gibson model choosing to not be an exact replica of what Adam Jones plays himself, because with this guitar, you know, it's very much a signature model, but with the range of tones you can get in it and with the fact it doesn't really scream Adam Jones, because you can actually take that truss rod cover off if you just want a plain one. It is worth mentioning as well that both neck profiles on each guitar are slightly different as well, with the Epiphone model actually going for the Adam Jones custom sort of neck profile, which I would imagine was really heavily based on his own guitars, because he does own quite a few 79 Silverbursts, them being his favorite guitar. The Epiphone is definitely kind of going for that more, I don't want to say authentic Adam Jones, because definitely both of them have got obviously that similar vibe to them, but as I'll touch on a little bit later, the Epiphone is definitely going for full force Adam Jones all the way, whereas the neck on the Gibson model is known as their rounded shape. It's a little bit more familiar if you do, you know, if you do play Les Pauls, if you more like just a kind of standard feel of it. Neither, I would say, I prefer, definitely both as good as each other, but the Epiphone model definitely has a slightly different feel to it, which you'll know what I mean if you get them in your hands, which, as with any guitar, go and try them. They're there to be played. You should get that reference in your hands so you know exactly what we're talking about. Because if you actually break it down, the humbucker that's in there, the obviously the finish, a couple of other little bits and bobs about it, it is just a really solid souped up Les Paul, especially if you want something that maybe can handle a bit more metally sort of side of things. What is definitely with the Epiphone model here, this, safe to say, I would probably say this is for somebody who's an absolute diehard Adam Jones fan. You know, you want the full thing, you want to be playing Tool riffs on this continuously. You don't mind, you know, his name being attached to it, and of course the absolutely gorgeous art pieces that are on the back as well, I think are incredibly sort of, you know, go hand in hand with Adam Jones as well, him being an artist and being into this more sort of expressionism, you know, on the back of your guitar, if that is even a word, to be fair. But both are amazing. It's definitely, it may sound completely, you know, a little bit false, but I've not had any more fun on each guitar than I have had with the other. You know, I've enjoyed both of them. I would probably just say that the biggest difference being that the Gibson is a bit more well-rounded in terms of moving into other genres, maybe into, you know, again, like if somebody's just looking for that sort of modded Les Paul but don't want to go through the effort of getting another pickup, getting it fitted, having obviously like a very era specific guitar. Whereas if you want it to be Tool time, then you go with the Epiphone. But what do you think after hearing the sound demos of both guitars compared to each other? Which one did you like the sound of better? Which one, I mean, looks better to you? Which one would you pick? Let us know in the comments just down below. You know what they're there for. Let us know what other artist signature models you'd like us to compare in the future as well. And for anything else, you can either get us on our website live chat or any of our socials just down below right there. But until next time, I've been Kieran. Have a great day.